Yeah, and it's a big problem. But we've got the Darwinian evolutionary theory, and then now it's kind of morphed into the Neo-Darwinian theory. Tell us the difference between those two.
Well, Neo-Darwinism is just the idea that natural selection is not only acting on random genetic variations, but also mutations, changes, random changes in the code that are essentially errors. They're random copying errors. And those random copying errors are thought to be the source of new innovation or new form in the history of life. And that raises a big problem, and this is really at the forefront of the Cambrian mystery. Think of it in terms of computer science. If you have a section of functioning computer code, and it forms a program, and you start randomly changing the digital characters, the zeros and ones, ask yourself a question. Are you more likely to degrade that information or to generate something fundamentally new?
Everybody here knows you got a big problem.
Big problem. You're going to degrade that information and cause the original code to be non-functional far before you would ever get to a new functioning software program or operating system. And the same thing has turned out to be true in the biological case. We've talked in previous episodes about the way in which DNA contains information in a digital form. And so if you want to take an existing organism that has DNA for building its proteins and structures and turn it into a new organism, you're going to have to change the DNA code. The Darwinian proposal is that that would happen randomly as a series of copying errors. But just as in the computer world, you're going to end up degrading that information long before you would ever get to a new gene capable of building new proteins and new anatomical structures. And this has actually been supported by experimental research. There's an Israeli protein scientist, a molecular biologist named Dan Tofik, recently passed away tragically, but his work was just absolutely fantastic. And what he did was experimentally test this idea. He looked at proteins and randomly changed the sequences of amino acids, which were a product of the DNA instruction. So if you get a change in the DNA, you get a change in the protein sequence. And what he found was that somewhere in each case between 3 and 15 changes in the amino acid sequences would result in a protein that degraded so much it would no longer fold. And that's not nearly enough change to turn one stable protein structure called a fold into another stable and functional protein structure, another protein fold. So you dip into an abyss of non-function before you ever get to something new. And so the digital character of the information that we now know is necessary to build new form and structure, new animals, like in the Cambrian, does not lend itself to random changes in a way that would help us to explain the origin of fundamentally new forms of life.